Get ready to match the stars. Sheldon Leonard, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Louisa Moritz, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Fly as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olsen and friends. We are surrounded by friends. And I mean, we're really surrounded.
May I say something?
Yes, you may say something.
What is the world coming to when one lady's bosom is covered with feathers and the other one has a stop sign on it?
Yes. I don't know. What is it coming to?
Feathers and stops.
I like feathers.
You like feathers, yes.
Yes.
And how about you?
I have another that says, look and listen.
Stop, look, and listen. We'll wait and see those.
Now, to hear those.
What'd you say?
And I'd like to hear those.
Let's say hello to Rick Latini and Laverta Fear. Rick is a current champ. He's won one game, and he has $600 to his credit. And now we're going to start a brand new game, and we're going to... he's going to be challenged by Laverta Fears, and we really haven't heard the story of your life, have we, Laverta? Would you please tell us now?
Oh, I am employed by Stevens and Loans, where I'm a supervisor of the insurance department. I have a 4.5-year-old daughter who has just started to school, and she's very excited.
Yes, I bet she is. That's a very exciting and sometimes a fearful event, isn't it? Does she look forward to it?
At school?
Yes.
Oh, she did, long time ago.
She's not afraid of it at all?
No.
Well, then, you're a very good mother. She has no insecurities, and she's a dandy child. Is she here?
No, I couldn't bring her.
Bring her next time, would you? I want to meet her. There.
Okay.
Now, we're going to start this game in a moment or so, but right now we got to do a little business with you, America, so pay attention. Now, we're ready to begin the game. Round one coming up, Laverta. A or B?
A, please.
Here we go. New game. Everybody plays. Evel Knievel said... He said, I'm going to jump my motorcycle over 100 cars, but just in case I come down a bit too soon, the last car is going to be a blank. Just in case I come down a bit too soon, the last car is going to be a blank.
I think I have it, but I'm not absolutely dead sure this time. Usually I am.
Okay.
Oh, hey, you want to see that?
I just peek at it, then.
Be careful. We don't let anybody.
All right. Okay.
What does that mean?
I don't know.
It's up to you.
We finished down here, waiting for Big Eddie. Big Eddie is having trouble.
I'm paralyzed.
His brain is not working.
It's working.
Okay, now it's working. It's working. Laverta, Evel Knievel said, I'm going to jump my motorcycle over 100 cars. But just in case I come down a bit too soon, the last car is going to be a...
bed.
A bed?
Yes.
The last car is going to be a bed. The last car is going to be a bed. All right. She said a bed, Sheldon. The audience booed her. Are they going to boo you?
I expect them to. Yes.
You packing a rod, Big Eddie?
I just want it known that anybody who boos too loud, this, you got to get out of the joint yet, you know. You're not home free. So, take the consequences. I said it's going to be a small one.
A small car.
And I hate myself for it. But
that's it. Your brain wasn't working too good. All right, Brett.
Is there an answer that fits this question? That's what I would like to...
Yes, of course there's an answer.
So wait until we come to Big
Chuck.
Charles. Yeah, to
I'm
Chuck.
I'm the one with the roses.
Yeah, oh, yes.
Only somebody that macho could wear roses and get away with it.
That's true.
I said, you know, they have, like, dummies.
Dummy
like a dummy car.
Yeah, a soft dummy
car. Dummy car. Have they all gone deaf out there?
If you don't boo her, she'll think you don't love her anymore. Charles?
Here's your popular favorite, Gene. The only conceivable answer, convertible.
Thank you. Is that the answer?
No. We really haven't come to the definitive answer yet.
Maybe I suppose Dickie Dawson will have the definitive answer.
Well, maybe.
Be surprised.
What do you say, Louisa?
Well, I say that...
I didn't know what to say, so I said, the last car is going to be a parachute.
Listen, is that...
Booming.
No. Leave her alone. She's wearing feathers. Yes. Is that the way Big Eddie sounds to you?
Yeah.
I didn't know I could get down that far.
Yes.
I mean, the voice.
Have you thought of having your adenoids removed? Evil Knievel said, I'm going to jump my motorcycle over 100 cars, but just in case it come down a bit too soon, the last car is going to be a...
Well, Charles, or Chuck, as we like to call you, I think the answer would be hearse.
Is that the definitive answer?
If you like a negative, destructive answer.
Yeah. Well, we do, Chuck.
I'm very optimistic.
Yes. Now, you, the lady on the end there, what's her name?
Patsy Neal.
You promised not to tell.
Yes. Now, you see, I thought the thing out logically. I was thinking if I were going to do that, I would want the last car to be a rubber car.
Yeah. Okay. That's all right, Fanny. Not bad. Okay. Nothing for you. Now, your first round question, Rick, is as follows. Marge said, I couldn't believe it. I lifted up the lid on my bathroom tank, and there was the tidy bowl man blanking behind his boat. There was a tidy bowl man blanking behind his boat. You know the tidy bowl man commercial. Have you seen those? You lift up the lid of the tank there. And there was the tidy bowl man. He's usually in the little boat there, but there he was blanking behind his boat there. All right.
Are we all ready?
We are all ready.
Who are we waiting for?
Guess you and Fanny. You and Fanny. Okay, here we go. She's got... Rick, you ready? Yes. Okay. Marge said, I couldn't believe it. I lit up the lid on my bathroom tank, and there was a tidy bowl man blanking behind his boat.
Going to the bathroom.
Well, I gotta say, he's gone for broke.
Yes, he is. Rick, in case this subject ever comes up again, the euphemism we use here is tinkling. Could you remember that, then? What do you say?
I'm not having... Yes, maybe that is the sense of what I said.
Tidying up. Yeah. You've never seen the commercial. Brett?
Oh, I've seen the... I said he was doing the breaststroke or swimming.
Or swimming.
So there wouldn't be any confusion.
Very good.
I thought he was
naturally
going to say
very good.
Oh, don't
go her. That's a good
answer.
Leave her alone there. Charles?
It's a lot more genteel than swimming. Tinkling.
Yes.
Don't get my roses upset. I said water skiing.
Water skiing is good, too. You can do all kinds of things in back of that boat there. What do you say, Louisa?
Well, I said the only thing he could possibly be doing behind his boat is what anybody always does behind their boat.
Tinkling. Don't ask me to go sailing with you.
Well, I don't get out of the boat.
All right. What do you say, Richard?
Usually doing
in the boat.
Even more.
Shh.
I hope you malt.
Tinkling.
Tinkling. Okay, for Richard, Rick over there. Now, Fanny?
Yes. I said that he was swimming in the nude. That's why she was so shocked.
That's a good answer, too. We had a number of very good answers there, and two matches for Rick, 2-0 the score at the end of round one. Now we've got this message for you. All right, here we go. Round one is over, round two coming up. And Laverta, would you make your selection?
A, please.
A? All right. Everything okay over there?
Thank you,
yeah. Yes, Doc.
Are you ready now? All right, listen carefully. Long John Silver said, he says, ah! Oh, Okay, now fill us your cards. All right. I says, I will never forget the day I retired from piracy, for on that day, me crew got together and they blanked me parrot. The day he retired from piracy, the crew got together and blanked me parrot. That's what Long John Silver said.
Could you do it again more straight? So we get the words. I mean, it's wonderful acting.
Long John Silver says, I'll never forget the day I retired from piracy.
Uh-huh.
The crew got together and blanked me parrot.
Oh, cute. Okay.
Cute?
Cute is not the word I'm looking for. You're wearing roses, aren't you?
Uh-huh.
He and Burt Reynolds.
Okay. Ready? Laverda. Long John Silver says, I'll never forget the day I retired from piracy. The whole crew got together that day, and they blanked me parrot. The crew blanked me parrot.
She heard you. She's just confused like the rest of us.
The day I retired from piracy, the crew blanked me parrot.
Parrot, you know.
Parrot, you know what a parrot,
parrot
is?
Parrot. Oh, no.
Plucked.
Plucked me parrot. When I talk, you shut up. Okay. Do we
all? Okay, yeah.
Oh, thanks. All right. Okay.
Okay.
Now, you.
Well, that brought up memories of an exotic dish that we once tried in a remote island of the South Seas. Cooked parrot.
Cooked parrot. The whole crew got together and cooked the parrot. Now, that's a good response. Brett?
I don't want any trouble. Over
yep.
there.
Right.
This is a definite match. It's just a, I said skinned and made a bra for Louisa.
Skimmed and made a bra.
Now, that's a match.
Skinned.
Well, if you skinned a parrot, you pluck it, skin it, snap it.
Skinned and plucking is not the same thing. Oh, no, no, it is. That's right.
It's not
no,
wait a
minute. Shut up!
You tell her, fat lady.
No, you see, if you skin the parrot, that's different. Plucking the feathers, the skin would remain on the parrot, you see. That's a little distinction there. Yes, Charles?
I don't do that for my own entertainment, you know. There are some people who can talk authoritatively about plucking the feathers out of live parrots, you know.
And some can't.
I have other ways of amusing myself.
What did you say?
Barbecued.
Barbecued. She said plucked. Okay.
Keep the rally down.
We are looking for a plucked parrot, my dear. May we see your answer?
I can't talk. You told me to shut up.
Now you can talk.
The crew didn't like the parrot, so I said they neuterized it.
They neuterized it. Okay. I guess, that would hurt more than if they pulled out their feathers. What'd you say?
I'm sorry, I said eight.
Eight.
The eighth of pair. And that means Rick is the winner. What do you have? Eight of pair. That's two for you. Stand by for a moment. Well, Laverda, was a short meeting.
Enjoyed it.
And a very pleasant meeting for us, and we hope you had a good time. We've got some gifts for you, together with our thanks for being on Match Game 75. Laverda Fears. Rick, you're up to $700, and you're going to play for over $5,000 now. Shall we start?
Okay.
We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Tongue blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250, and the bottom one gets you $100. Whom do you call on?
Brett.
How about tongue-in-cheek?
Tongue-in-cheek is one.
Charles.
That terrific popular favorite. I mean, forget your hamburgers, forget your popcorn, get your tongue sandwich.
Tongue sandwich.
Richard.
Richard?
Tongue out of cheek? No.
No.
That's I'll give a tongue lashing.
Tongue lashing.
An old pirate.
Tongue lashing.
I got the one that's going to be the top.
You haven't been requested to speak yet, Louisa.
So you got tongue lashing, tongue in cheek, and tongue sandwich. Do you want one of those? You may have a better idea.
I think I'm going to go with tongue depressor.
tongue depressor.
Can I say one? I gotta say what this is gonna
You may say
one. Tongue twister.
Tongue twister. That's very good, Louisa.
My sandwich is going to be there.
All right. Now, tongue depressor, he's going with his own idea. We're going to find out if he's right or wrong right now. Let's get over there now and reveal the $100 response. Louisa, that was your answer.
That was
tongue
cheesy.
Twister. Okay, let's see if tongue depressor is now onto the $250 response. Tongue tie. That's a very good one. I didn't think of that one at all. Did you? Last chance for tongue depressor. Here is the $500 response.
Tongue in cheek.
Tongue in cheek was Brett's answer.
Yes, darling.
Very good.
So am I.
Well, Rick, you picked up another $100. You're going to meet another player in a moment or so, but right now we've got this message for you. There we go, friends there. Are you ready to meet this lady? All right, then please applaud her politely and generously. Madeline Clift. How are you, Madeline?
Fine.
Good. Now, we would like to find out as much as we can about you in a short period of time. What do you say?
Okay. I'm originally from Visalia, which is by the big town of Fresno.
Yeah.
And I work part-time. I'm married. I have a 4-year-old son, and I'm expecting another one in March.
In March.
Yeah.
Okay. Feel all right?
No, I think I'm going to have it right now.
No. No, it's very easy here. We're a very friendly bunch here. We're very loose, and the rules are simple, and you know you got a choice here of A or B, Madeline.
B, please.
B it is. New game. Everybody plays, and it goes like this. The Countess Dracula said,
My husband, the Count, has gotten very civilized. Now, before he bites you on the neck, he blinks.
The Countess said, I have that. She's a little bit of a sissy in the Count's wife, isn't there?
Most women speak with a hiss.
Oh, I see.
See?
I never realized that before.
That's the way they
actually
talk. She says, now, before he bites you on the neck, he blinks.
The whole thing again, the first thing.
The Countess Dracula said, my husband, the Count, has gotten very civilized now.
Right.
Now, before he bites you on the neck, he blinks.
I have that.
He's more civilized.
That's not comparatively simple, Charles.
All right. Now, before he bites you on the neck, he blinks. He blinks. He's gotten civilized, you see. So before he bites you, he blinks. All right. Who's finished? They are finished, and they are finished. So we come over here to Madeline Clift. The Countess Dracula said,
my husband, the Count, has gotten very civilized. Now, before he bites you on the neck, he blinks.
Washes his face?
He washes his face. That's a cute idea. Now, wait a minute. That would be a nice, polite, civilized thing to do. You know, like you... Didn't your mother say, wash your hands before you come to the dinner table? So he washes his face before he goes to his dinner table.
What do you say, Big Eddie?
My answer depends on a somewhat different interpretation of the reading than you gave it. You said, before he bites you on the neck, he blanks. And I say, it should be read, before he bites you on the neck, he belches.
All right. You held it upside down, Big Eddie.
Did I?
Yes, yes, sir.
It was an upside down belch.
That's why he belched. He was upside down. What do you say?
I say he comes right over, he taps you on your little shoulder, and he says, asks.
Yes, that's polite, yes. May I?
May I?
Charles.
When he was a teenager, the first woman he bit was the Baroness Grace Lamorento. So out of respect, believe it or not, this will get a laugh. Out of respect to the Countess,
here.
Baroness, or whatever she was, he says grace before.
He says grace.
I loved it.
Yes. He says, grace, may I bite you on the neck?
Yes.
No. What do you say?
Before anybody bites you on the neck, you should always knock on your head.
You know, you really are a weirdo. But cute.
Oh, it's not my command.
That's right.
Could I hear the question again, please?
May I bite your neck?
The Countess Dracula said, "My husband, the Count, has gotten very civilized. Now, before he bites you on the neck, he blanks."
He says, "Excuse me."
Excuse me.
What do you say, Fanny?
I said, before he does it, he said, "I'm so sorry, honey."
He apologized. So, Wash's face did not come up at all. So, we're in the middle of round one. Your question will come along in a moment or so, but right now we got this message for you. 35 seconds to say goodbye.
Bye.
Say goodbye.
Bye.
Goodbye. Got another 20 seconds. Keep saying it.
Bye.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Say bye. So long. Bye. You come back next time, right? Okay, goodbye, Madeline. Goodbye, Rick, there. You got another 10 seconds to say goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Friday.
All right.
Friday at 8 o'clock, I want you to watch Big Eddie.
Bull, Friday at 8 o'clock.
Here.
Everybody go and watch. We got right on this CBS station.
Okay.
Gene Rayburn here. Match game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.